there! Welcome back to the VSDC channel. Today we've got something exciting for you. We're going to show you how to create a captivating and unique logo and then take it to the next level by adding some awesome animations using the updated perspective tool in VSDC 8.2. If you haven't updated your software yet, now is the time. Just follow the link in the description or check for updates in the activation tab. Alright, let's dive right in and get started. To begin, create a new project with a full HD resolution and set the background opacity to 0. This will give us a clean slate to work with. Now, let's create the foundation of our logo. We need to add a rectangle onto the scene. Locate the rectangle object on the left vertical panel next to the scene, or simply press Shift-R. Navigate to the Properties window and set the following coordinates: top 150, width 1700, height 50. Change the brush color to black and the pen type to transparent. Align the rectangle horizontally through the center using the alignment tool. Then, duplicate the rectangle 6 more times, adjusting the top parameter by plus 100 pixels each time. Start with 250 and finish with 750 pixels as top parameter. This will give us 7 evenly spaced stripes on the scene, creating a sleek and modern background for the logo. Next up, we'll add an arrow as a logo object itself. Choose arrow number 4 from the free shape gallery on the left vertical panel. Draw the shape on the scene. We will use this arrow as a mask for a cool animation later. Now it's time to position the arrow correctly. Set its top parameter to 150 and its width and height to 650. Then rotate it minus 90 degrees through Rotate Effect to make it face up. Lastly, change the arrow's fill color to black. This will allow us to use it as a mask for our logo animation. Make sure that the arrow is on the top layer. Change its blending mode to inverted mask. Before we proceed with the animation, add a text to our logo. Locate the text box on the left vertical panel, create it on the scene as illustrated, and type the name of your company or brand. Also create a copy of any rectangle line and set its top parameter to 920. Set its width to 700 and height at 20. To make it look professional, align the text and the rectangle line horizontally through their centers. This will give our logo a perfect balance. Alright, now comes the exciting part, animating our logo's appearance using the awesome perspective effect. To get started, convert all the objects on the scene into a sprite. Don't worry, it's easy. Just select all objects on the scene, right-click, and you'll find the option Convert to Sprite. This step is essential because we can't directly apply effects to Scene 0. Navigate to the Sprite Properties window and set the following parameters. Uses Container? No. Show Effects? Yes. Brush Type? Transparent. With the sprite ready, it's time to apply the perspective effect. This will give our logo a cool 3D-like animation. Simply select the sprite and apply the effect. You can find it in Editor, Video Effects, Transforms, Perspective. Move the perspective object below the text and the rectangle line, for them not to be affected by the arrow mask. Temporarily disable the visibility of these two upper layers. We'll come back to them at a later stage. Now, select the perspective effect and navigate to the Properties window. We will study what options are available and how to create animation. Expand the perspective angles parameter and set the initial angle at 90 degrees and the final angle at 0, creating animation of appearance. To keep it snappy, set the effect duration to 2 seconds. Now, let's take care of any artifacts that may appear. Change the anti-aliasing mode to without anti-aliasing. If there are still some artifacts, don't worry. The animation is there, but we want more. We want to take one step further and change the perspective mode to bind to service points. To activate this mode, you have two options. Manually create tracking points and then select them in the properties window as binding points, or automatically create them by clicking on the Add Tracking Point button in the properties window. These points will be linked to the parent size, and in our case, the parent is the sprite. Now, let's experiment with perspective modes. You can try out the replicate mode in both clipping and reflected styles. In the reflected style, try to move the upper left tracking point to the upper right corner and animate the movement of this point. Double-click the effect, find this point, and apply the movement effect from the current position back to the left corner. There's also the bilinear bound mode, perfect for revealing the backside of your logo. Select the upper right point and move it to the left. Add the movement animation to this point to move it back to the initial position. For now, let's stick to the regular perspective mode with clipping replicate. We can make the upper left point move to the bottom center, while the upper right point goes to the upper left corner. It's these little animations that make our logo stand out. Change the perspective interpolation mode to cubic to avoid any artifacts after export. Almost there! Now, let's animate the text and the rectangle line. Bring back their visibility and let's make our logo shine. For the text, we will apply a smooth fade-in effect using the recoloring effect. It'll give our logo a professional touch. As for the rectangle line, we will make it draw itself into the scene using the zoom effect. Place the center of the effect at the line's starting point and animate its size gradually increasing from 0 to 100% along the x-axis. Great job! Our logo is looking fantastic with all these animations. Finally, position the rectangle line and text objects right after the perspective effect stops and the logo appears. This will give us a smooth transition. And there you have it! Your stunning logo animation is now complete. To save the logo with a transparent background, follow these steps. Navigate to the Export Project tab. Select MOV, MKV, or AVI format in the upper panel. Click on Edit Profile, locate the Video Codec drop-down menu in the Video Settings area, and select PNG Lossless from the options. This will ensure your logo retains transparent background. Now you can easily overlay your logo on other videos, creating a seamless and professional look. However, if a transparent background is not what you need, simply create a rectangle that will serve as a background on scene 0. Place it on the lowest layer and assign a color to it. Then, export the video using your preferred export settings. We really hope you enjoyed this tutorial as much as we did creating it. Be sure to hit that like button, subscribe to the VSDC channel, and share your awesome logo animations with us. Thanks for watching, and see you next time!